In today's video, we return to legal risks and risk mitigation for a healthcare startup deploying IV therapies. Hi everyone, I'm Michael H. Cohen. I'm founding attorney of the Cohen Healthcare Law Group. We help healthcare industry clients just like you navigate healthcare and FDA legal issues so you can grow or launch your healthcare business. Previously, we talked about FTC enforcement with respect to claims made by certain IV manufacturers and clinics. FTC had found the claims about treatment for diseases to be deceptive and misleading. Now, FTC is a powerful legal watchdog when it comes to your marketing, and they're state regulators too. There are also other legal risks besides deceptive advertising when you are providing IV therapies. They're not necessarily insurmountable, but you have to know about the risks and how to mitigate them. So, for example, let's just say that our client Bob comes to us with these legal questions. Hi, I'm Bob, Dr. Bob. I'm an MD. I've got a professional medical corporation in which I own 51% of the shares and my RN owns 49%. Let's say we also co-own the MSO or technology platform. Can we set this up so that 99% of our profits flow to the technology platform, which is the venture? Because then we can sell that and get rich. Well, no, that would violate the corporate practice of medicine and as well possibly constitute fee splitting. You just can't suck all the profit out of the professional medical clinical side and stick it in the MSO. The reason is the MSO has to earn its fees at fair market value for the services and technology it provides. Bob's second question, can I hire a medical director for the venture? We get this question a lot. I mean, we typically disfavor the concept of a medical director because it makes it look like you've got the venture hiring the doctor. It's better to have this structure that we typically use where there are two entities. One's the clinical and the other's the management and marketing company. So we call that the MSO model. Okay, now three, is this gonna violate self-referral and Stark if I refer patients for my practice? Well, not necessarily, because these self-referral laws only apply when you have DHS, designated health services. So if you don't have DHS, then you might not have a Stark issue, but you might have anti-kickback laws to worry about. And fourth, completely different topic, can the RN prescribe medications? The answer is no. Typically, the physician must be the prescriber, and the RN would be the one furnishing and administering to the patient. In California, licensed RNs are able to administer medications and therapeutic agents that are ordered by and within the scope of practice of a physician, dentist, podiatrist, or clinical psychologist, as long as within their scope of practice. So you see, when you get a puzzle like this, it might seem like there are clear lines in the way I phrase the questions. There might be unambiguous yeses and nos, but more typically what you've got to do is navigate all these different components of healthcare law. Some are more nuanced than others. So that's how you navigate with more knowledge and assurance about the legal boundaries, risks, and regulatory pitfalls. Thanks for watching. Please contact us with your questions. We've helped hundreds and hundreds of healthcare industry clients build their dream. We look forward to working with you on your journey to success.